Good morning, students. I welcome you all once again in my class. And I'm Manoj sir from Hope Academy, Belaspur. I'm very excited to come before you in this manner when we are locked down and we are starting our lectures, our classes online. We are so happy. And also, thank you so much for joining me. Thank you for subscribing my channel and sharing my channel. I hope you are enjoying the classes. And in this video, we are going to learn, we are going to start your new chapter, that is Introduction to Trigonometry. And this chapter is very, very important, very, very interesting also. And in our daily life, we use this concept to solve different kinds of problems. For example, if we consider one example, if I say the student of schools are visiting Qutub Minar. Now, if a student is looking at the top of the minar, a right triangle can be imagined to be made. So, in this case, if you want to find out the height of the Qutub Minar, so you can use the concept of trigonometry to get the your answer. Okay? So, trigonometry is all about the triangles, and particularly it is about right triangles. Right triangle is what? We already know in triangle there are three sides and three angles, and if in triangle one angle is 90 degree, so we say that triangle is what? Right triangle. So trigonometry concept is all about the right triangle, where we use the concept, the relationship between sides and angles. And if we know the measurement of the angle and sides, so we can find out other unknown sides or unknown angle. Okay. So here we have given one example. We will see further few more examples. Suppose a girl is sitting on the balcony of her house located on a bank of a river. You can see this in a diagram. If she is looking down at a flower pot placed on a stair of campus nearby the other bank of the river. Okay. So in this case, the right triangle is imagined to be made. And if you want to find out the width of the river, so to calculate the width of the river, you need to use the concept of trigonometry. And the concept of trigonometry will make you very easy to find out the width of the river. Okay? So suppose we'll consider a third case where you will understood the concept of right triangle and the concept of trigonometry also. Suppose a hot air balloon is flying in the air. A girl is happens to spot the balloon in the sky and runs to her mother to tell her about it. Her mother rushes out of the house to look at the balloon. Now, when the girl had spotted the balloon, initially it was a point A. Okay. When both the mother and daughter came out to see it, it had already traveled another point called B. So, in this case, if you want to find out the altitude of the balloon at point B from the land, so you can imagine a right triangle. The eyes of the girl and mother and top of the balloon and land. So that will make your right triangle. And if you are getting right triangle, so with the help of concept of trigonometry, you can find out the altitude of the balloon. So in all these situations given above, the distance or heights can be found by using some mathematical techniques, which come under the branch of mathematics called trigonometry. Okay, so if you want to find out the height and width, so where a right triangle is made, so you can use the your concept of trigonometry. So before moving forward, let me give you some introduction about trigonometry. The word trigonometry is derived from the Greek word tri, and the meaning of tri is what? Three. Another word gon, meaning of gon is sides, and another word matron. Matron means measure. So trigonometry word itself has three words, that is tri, gon and matron. Tri is what? Three. Gon is sides, and matron is what? Measure. So the trigonometry is what? It is all about the measurement of three sides. In fact, trigonometry is the study of the relationship between the sides and the angles of a triangle. Okay, so the earliest known work on trigonometry was recorded in Egypt and Babylon. Okay, this two country, this two city was very huge city in earliest time, and Egypt and Babylonians Egyptian and Babylonians used the concept of trigonometry. Early astronomers used it to find out the distance of the stars and planets from the Earth. Even today, most of the technological advanced method used in engineering and physical science are based on the trigonometrical concept. So, trigonometry is very, very important in the field of engineering and physics, okay? And it is very, very important topic in your mathematics also. So, according to Mr. J.F. Herbert, he quoted, "There is perhaps nothing which so occupies the middle position of the mathematics as trigonometry." So, here he says that trigonometry is what? Middle position of mathematics. Okay, we can put trigonometry in the middle position of the mathematics. So, this concept is very important and very interesting, and I hope that you are going to enjoy this session. Okay, so moving forward to your next, in this chapter what we are going to learn, let me give you some basic things. In this chapter we are going to learn about the right triangle, okay, and in right triangle we are going to learn about the ratios of the angle. And very especially, we will speak about acute angle. You already know what is acute angle. Angle which is less than 90 degrees is what? Acute angle. So, in the concept of trigonometry, we will use acute angle, and we will find out the ratios of the angle, and also we will find out the ratios of the sides. Further, we will discuss about the measure like 0 degree and 90 degree to solve your problems. Okay, and we will also see some trigonometric identities. Identities are nothing but your rules, or you can say formulas, which we are going to see in this lecture. And also we will learn to use those identities and ratios to solve numerical problems. Thank you.